So let's start now our journey with the chapter called Working Capital Management. So let's have the introduction of working capital. So what exactly is working capital? Let's have its introduction first. Working capital may be regarded as the lifeblood of a business. It is the most vital ingredients of a business. Its effective provision can do much to ensure the success of a business, but its inefficient management can lead not only to the loss of profits, but also to the downfall of a business. So it is very important to manage working capital. If the company is not able to manage it properly, it may be result into heavy losses for the company. Instead of earning profit, it may earn loss, it may do loss. And what will happen, sir? There may be a necessity of closing down the business. The study of working capital is of major importance, internal as well as for external analysis, because of its close relationship with the current day-to-day operations of a business. So we will try to understand that also. Now, what is the definition of working capital? That we will try to understand. Working capital is formally arrived at by subtracting the current liabilities from current assets, which we have studied in UG level also, at our school level also. So subtracting the current liabilities from current asset of a firm, of a day, of balance sheet, it is drawn up. So on the date of preparing balance sheet, if we subtract current liability from current asset, we will receive what? Working capital in simple words. So working capital is also represented by a firm's net investment in current assets. It is also known as what? Net investment in current assets, necessary to support its everyday business. So working capital frequently changes its forms and is sometimes also referred to as circulating capital, maybe fluctuating capital, maybe revolving capital. So according to Gretzenberg, what he makes us clear about the concept called working capital, in his words, let us try to understand. The capital of a business which is used in its day-to-day trading operation. So for daily trading or routine trading, for routine operation of a business, it is a requirement, continuous requirement of working capital is needed. The working capital of an organization can be calculated by using the following formula. So working capital is nothing but you know very well what it is. It is current asset minus current liability. So let's have now a brief idea of concept of working capital. Working capital to a company is like the blood to human body. Without working capital, company cannot survive. Working capital management, if carried out effectively, efficiently, and constantly, will assure the health of the organization. So, as a manager of the company, it is the duty of the manager that he is supposed to manage working capital effectively, efficiently, and consistently. There should be no defects in maintaining or managing working capital. So in simple words, working capital is defined as the excess of current asset over current liabilities. And this concept can be elaborated into two ways. Basically, there are two concepts of working capital, that is gross working capital concept and net working capital concept. So let us understand one by one what is gross working capital and what is net working capital. So first, under we will try to focus on gross working capital. What is gross working capital? The gross working capital usually referred to as working capital represents investment in current assets, investment in current assets such as marketable securities, inventories, and bills receivable. So gross working capital basically deals with what? Investment which is made in current assets only. That is marketable securities, inventories, and bills receivables. There, here current assets are those assets which are normally converted into cash within 1 year. So they are also, we can say they are liquid assets. Current assets include liquid assets, basically like cash, which the assets which can be easily converted into cash. So in simple words, if I want to explain gross working capital, I can say that gross working capital refers to investment in all current assets. Investment in all current assets such as raw materials, work in progress, finished goods, book debts, cash balance, and bank balance. What about net working capital? What is net working capital? That is what we are learning from the initial stage, from this topic only. The net working capital usually referred to as working capital represents the difference between current asset and current liability. That is, current asset minus current liability is nothing but net working capital. So current liabilities are those claims of outsiders which are expected to mature for payment within 1 year and includes creditors, bills payable, bank overdraft, and outstanding expenses such as wages, salary, dividend payable, and tax payable, bank overdraft, etc. So what exactly current assets are included, what exactly which type of current liabilities are included, that has been elaborated in this slide. So creditors, bills payable, bank OD, all these liabilities are considered as current liabilities, and they generally are paid within a year. They are converted into cash within a year, and companies are supposed to make payment of such patterns of liability, such types of liability. The net working capital can be positive or negative. When the current asset exceeds current liability, what will happen? Say, for example, if current asset exceeds current liability, what will happen? Sir, the net working capital becomes positive. Net working capital becomes positive. If asset is more than liability, what will happen, sir? The net working capital becomes positive. It is a good sign for company. The company has a good liquidity position, we can say that. But if the situation is reversed, when current liability exceeds current assets, what will happen? The net working capital becomes negative. If liability is more than asset, if current liability is more than current asset, then we can say that the net working capital becomes negative. It shows bad liquidity position of the company. So to maintain net working capital is equally important for any organization, for any business concern. So the net and gross concept of working capital have functional significance. The gross working capital concept is financial or going concern concept. Financial, or we can say it is a going concern concept, and deals with the problem of managing individual current assets in short run, or we can say short term. So gross working capital is useful, or this concept is used in short run or in short requirement of funds. While in case of net working capital concept is an accounting concept, and deals with management of net value of current asset in the long run. Yes, any problem in between? Just mute your mic. The net working capital concept is an accounting concept and deals with management of net value of current asset in the long run. So there is a difference between gross working capital and net working capital in terms of duration. For short requirement, short-term requirement, gross working capital concept is favorable for the firm. And if the requirement of working capital is for long run, then the company should prefer net working capital concept. So moving further, gross and net concept of working capital have their own merits, their own advantages. The net concept of working capital may be suitable only for proprietary form of organization, sole trader, partnership firm, etc. Who will follow net concept of working capital, sir? Proprietary form of organizations, maybe sole trader, maybe one person company, maybe partnership firm, maybe a small company, etc. But in case of gross concept of working capital, it is suitable to the company form of organization. So majority of the companies which are of giant nature, they will prefer to follow gross concept of working capital. Now there are certain types of working capital that let us have its brief idea. There are two kinds of working capital. One is permanent working capital, while the other one is temporary working capital. Let us first understand what is permanent working capital. Permanent working capital refers to minimum amount of all current assets that is required at all times to ensure a minimum level of uninterrupted business operations. Some minimum level of raw materials, working progress, bank balance, finished goods, etc. A business has to carry all the time, irrespective of the level of their operations. This level of working capital is referred to as a core working capital. Permanent working capital is also defined as amount of current asset required to meet a firm's long-term minimum. For a growing business, the permanent working capital will be rising. For a growing business, the permanent working capital will be rising. For a declining business, it will be decreasing. And for a stable business, it will be remaining more or less, depending on the situation. So permanent working capital is like fixed working capital, which is also divided further into two parts. Initial working capital, regular working capital. Now, what is initial working capital? In the initial period of firm's operation, it must need enough money. It must need enough money to pay certain expenses, like, say, for example, preliminary expenses for the incorporation of the company. In the initial years, the banks may not grant loans or overdrafts. Sales may have to be made on credit, and it may be necessary to pay the creditors immediately. Therefore, the owners themselves have to provide necessary funds in the initial period which may be known as initial working capital. So at the initial stage, the owners are supposed to make payments out of their own funds. And if they make certain payments from their own funds at the inception, at the initial stage, also you can say it is a seed capital. Also, we can say that. So such initial capital, working capital is needed for each and every pattern of organization. Now, let us try to understand regular working capital. What is regular working capital? The firm is always required to keep certain funds with it to continue the regular business operations. So for regular business operations, the firm requires certain funds, which is known as regular working capital. Continuously, you need such patterns of funds, such type of funds to meet the daily requirement. It is required to maintain regular stock of raw materials and work in progress and also finished goods, which must be maintained permanently at a definite level. So, in simple words, if I want to make you understand what is regular working capital, it is the excess of current asset over current liability. It ensures smooth operation of business. So, from the above discussion, it is clear that permanent working capital is nothing but it's a fixed working capital which is needed to maintain the business operations of the company, of the organization smoothly. Initial working capital is also needed to start the company and then to run the company on regular basis. Regular working capital is also must. Now let us try to understand additional, or we can say temporary or varying working capital. First of all, we will try to understand temporary working capital. Temporary working capital varies with the volume of operations, with the volume of operations. It fluctuates with the scale of operations. This is also known as additional working capital required during seasons over the above of fixed working capital. So we need fixed capital that is called permanent working capital. With that, additional capital may also be needed to the company depending on the requirement, interim requirement of the company. During seasons, more production or sales takes place, resulting in larger working capital needs. The reverse is true during off-season, as season alters. Temporary working capital moves up and down like the tides of the river. So, friends, temporary working capital is defined as amount of current asset that varies with seasonal requirements, with seasonal requirements. So the amount of temporary working capital is changing as per the need, as per the requirement of the company. It may increase, depends on the season. It may decrease depending on the season. Temporary working capital can be financed through short-term funds, that is, current liabilities. When the level of temporary working capital moves up, the business might use short-term funds. So this temporary working capital is also further divided into seasonal working capital, and we can say special or contingency working capital. Let us now try to understand what is seasonal working capital. Some business operations requires additional working capital during a particular season. For example, the groundnut oil producers may have to purchase groundnut in a particular season and have to employ additional labor for that purpose. This may require additional funds for a temporary period, which may be called as seasonal working capital. So depending on the season, depending on the type of business, depending on the nature of the business, the additional working capital may fluctuate. In peak season, more working capital is needed, while in off season, less working capital will be needed to the organization. The last one is special working capital. In all enterprises, some unforeseen events, or we can say contingent events, do occur, like sudden increase in demand, downward movement of price of raw material, strikes, natural calamities, when extra funds are needed to come over with such situations. Such type of extra funds are nothing but they are called as special working capital.